in Matthew chapter 13. And I'm sure I'll give you some more scriptures as we get into this morning message. While you're doing that, I'm going to pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this wonderful privilege to assemble together in your name again. For it is in your name that we do assemble. You said in your word that wherever two or three were gathered together in your name, that you would be in the midst. That's more than two or three of us here, so we know that you're already here. And we're asking that you would give unto us the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of you, the eyes of our understanding being enlightened, that we may know what is the hope of your calling. Give us receptive hearts and listening ears. We bind any way the enemy may try to block our thoughts, vision, or revelation, or to hinder the word of God, or the free flow of, in Jesus' name. Devil, we come against you as a unified body, reminding you that you are bound. You cannot and will not hinder the word in any shape, form, or fashion. We cast you out of our minds and out of this service in Jesus' name. Father, thank you now for the ministry of the angels that move up and down the aisles to help us minister and share this word in clarity and simplicity. And for everything that's said and done in your name, we're going to give you the praise, glory, and honor. And everyone in agreement says, amen, 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 and amen. Glory to God. You know, for the last several, last probably about month and a half, we've been talking to you about filters. And the reason why we've been talking to you about filters is because of a word that God gave us at the beginning of the year about ascending. What was that word? Don't stop ascending. Don't stop ascending. And so every message that I've been giving you so far this year is about what will stop you or hinder you from ascending. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Or what you must do to ascend. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And if we want to ascend, listen to this, we got to get rid of the filters. Thank you, Lord Jesus, because they are definitely keeping us from ascending and going higher. And we told you one of the reasons why we want to ascend and go higher is because we don't want to end up on God's spiritual junk heap. That is no longer usable. I don't know about you, but we're right on the cusp and the brink of a new and fresh move of God. I don't want to be one of those that's no longer usable. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I'm like the songwriter say, Lord, whatever it is that you're doing, please don't do it without me. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I want to be a part of this last day move. How about you? Thank you, Lord Jesus. Well, in order to do that, we got to keep ascending. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We can't just sit around not doing anything. If you do, you're sitting down on your gifts and your talents and abilities, and God is going to eventually put you on his spiritual junk heap. And I've seen many ministers with great anointings and great ministries that, you know, they kind of fell by the wayside, so to speak, and God put them on his spiritual junk heap. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I remember them when at one time or another, man, they had the most popular ministry around. I remember when they had one of the greatest anointings. But to look at them now, it's like, my God, what has happened to this great man and woman of God? They landed on God's spiritual junk heap. Let's not look bad upon them. What about us? What about you? Remember one time when, I mean, you were on fire? Remember one time when you had the anointing? Remember one time it was, I mean, you know, you, all night was all right, and you didn't mind going to church, and you didn't mind doing things in the church? Thank you, Lord Jesus. No, sir. No, ma'am. We do not want to fall on God's spiritual junk heap. Thank you, Lord Jesus. What we're going to talk about this morning is I'm going to mix what God gave me at the beginning of the year and also what God gave Jerry Savelle. And I don't know if you've been looking at any of his teachings, but Jerry Savelle, what God gave him at the beginning of the year. And God say, both of you all's message are basically one and the same. I'm going to show you that when we get off into it. But the message that God gave Jerry Savelle at the beginning of the year was, you know, the year of the maximum. The year of the maximum, that is how to reach the highest level obtainable. The year of the maximum, how to reach the highest level attainable. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And that's what we're going to talk about this morning, the highest level attainable. Over in Philippians chapter 3, verse 13, the Apostle Paul said, brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended. In other words, I have not arrived. Thank you, Lord Jesus. He said, but this one thing I do, listen to this, I'm forgetting those things which are behind, and I'm reaching forth unto those things which are before. Listen now, verse 14, I press toward the mark of the prize, listen to this, of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. I press toward the mark of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In other words, Paul say, I'm reaching for the maximum. I'm reaching for the maximum. In other words, Paul said, I'm reaching for the highest level attainable. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Let's look in Matthew 13, verse 23. Jesus said, but he that receives seed into the good ground is he that heareth the word and understandeth it, which also bringeth forth fruit, or beareth fruit. Some, listen to this, some 100-fold, some 60, and some 30. Some 100-fold, some 60, and some 30. What's 100-fold? 100-fold is the highest level obtainable. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In other words, you know, we talk about being 100. You know, I'm 100. Boy, I mean, you know, hey, you 100. I mean, that, boy, this is 100. We talk about being 100. What do we mean when we say that? We're talking about the highest level attainable. We're talking about we can't go, we done level off. Thank you, Lord Jesus. The Lord told Jerry Savelle, this is the year of the maximum. In other words, I want you to reach for the highest level attainable. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Well, Pastor, how are we going to reach for the highest level attainable when we ain't reaching at all? You know, because you got some out there, you know, you're talking about 30, 60, and 100. They're not even at 30. They're at 15. They're at 5. They're at 10. Some is just breaking even. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Well, let's get into talking about this, because I want you to know that God wants us to reach for the highest level attainable. Thank you, Lord Jesus. At the end of last year, the word of the Lord came unto me concerning 2023, and that was, don't stop ascending. Up until this point, every message I have shared has been centered around what it takes for us to go higher and to continue to ascend. Like I told you when we talked about filters, you know, if we want to ascend, we got to get rid of the filters and add the filter of the word of God if we want to ascend. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I want to continue to talk along the lines of ascending, but again, I want to add in what God told Jerry Savelle as well, reaching for the maximum in obtaining the highest level, reaching the highest level. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Now, with Jerry Savelle, in his teachings, and you got to understand his ministry. I mean, you know, Jerry is probably one of the foremost teachers in the body of Christ when it comes to prosperity in giving. One of the foremost teachers. Thank you, Lord Jesus. So I understand his ministry. So Jerry, from the standpoint of giving and receiving, he's teaching this level, from the how to receive the highest level attainable, basically on what you give. Thank you, Lord Jesus. So he's teaching from the standpoint of giving and receiving. But the Lord say, no, that word is for more than just giving and receiving. That's for anything when it comes to me, in any area. I want you to reach for the highest level attainable. Thank you, Lord Jesus. That's not just for financials. You know, like for instance, if it comes to talking about a healing in your body, he said, I want you to reach for the highest level attainable. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Let's not just reach for healing. Let's reach for divine health. That's the highest level attainable. Thank you, Lord Jesus. When it comes to your finances and wealth, thank you, Lord Jesus. Don't just reach to get your needs met. Don't just look just to get your needs met. He said, look to get everything paid off and have money in store. The highest level attainable. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You know, concerning this property that we're on right now, we're praying and believing God that it's our property. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And, you know, and I was telling the Lord, I said, well, Lord, and we, me and my wife been talking, we're just going to have to believe you for the necessary favor and finances to come in so that we can, acquire this property. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And I heard the Lord say, why do you want to just stop there? You know there's a whole bunch of work that needs to be done on that property and around that property. He said, why not reach for the highest level obtainable? Not only get the property and get it paid off, but also get the property renovated. Get everything renewed. Get everything restored. He said, that's the highest level attainable. Are y'all hearing me? He say, why are you just settling for, and I'm getting way ahead of myself, why are you just settling for crumbs that fall from the master's table? He say, crumbs are for dogs. Oh my goodness, don't look at me funny, I'm not calling you a dog. The dog that he was talking about in scripture was the unbeliever. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Remember when the Syrophoenician woman came to him about her daughter? And she wasn't a part of Israel or the chosen people. And that's why he first of all, he didn't pay no attention. And then secondly, when he turned to her, he said, it's not meat that takes the church's bread and to cast it unto dogs. Call them dogs. Thank you, Lord Jesus. But she said, truth, Lord, but the dogs eat from the crumbs from the... So the world, they're considered the dogs. And why are we settling for their crumbs when there's a four-course meal on the table? That's the highest level attainable. Let's go for that. Thank you, Lord Jesus. When we just settle for, Sharon, when we just settle for healing, that's a crumb. You want divine health. You want wholeness. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In years past, I've had chronic conditions in my body that I've been constantly dealing with. Thank you, Lord Jesus. The Lord said, don't stop at healing, go for wholeness. Oh, I'm finna blow somebody's mind right now. I'm finna blow somebody's mind right now. If you're in a wheelchair and you're missing two limbs, don't just go for walking. Get you two legs. If you're missing a limb, get another limb. You know, the Lord said something to me a long time ago. He said, nobody is trying to believe me for the maximum. Nobody's trying to believe me for the highest level of obtainable. He said, when he starts quoting those scriptures to me over in Matthew, that if two of you shall agree on earth as touching anything that they shall ask, whatever you bind, whatever you loose, and then, whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and if you believe anything in my name, I will do it. He said, nobody is believing me for the miraculous. Nobody is believing me for the impossible. Nobody is believing me for the ridiculous. He said, nobody's even trying to believe me for that. He said, but yet I said you can do it. Because I asked the Lord, can I really believe for that? Can we really believe for that? He said, I wouldn't have said it if you couldn't. Did you get that? He said, I wouldn't have said it if you couldn't. You got to know this, Mr. and Mrs. Believer. Every last one of us is capable, as a believer, every last one of us is capable of believing God for the maximum. We're capable of it. You may not do it, but you're capable of it. Amen. Oh, that was good right there. You may not do it, but you're capable of it. Think about it. You're capable of believing God, Bob, for everything to be paid off with more than enough in a store account to pay somebody else's off. You're capable of believing for that, of doing it. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Nick, you're capable of having somebody run your whole business while you're out there casting out devils, healing the sick and raising the dead. You're capable of it. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Now, God said, my children is capable of, now get this. He said, I desire to do greatly for my children. He said, okay, Lord, I hear you. When he said, when he cursed the fig tree, he said, if you truly believe me, you would not only do this what I've done to the fig tree, but also if you would say unto this mountain. He said, if you truly believe me, you would not only do what I have done. If you truly believe me, you would not only do what I have done. If you truly believe me, you would not only do what I have done to the fig tree. In other words, if I see some weeds or something growing around in my yard or in my garden, I'm just going to curse them in Jesus' name. We're going to get out there and work and pulling up, doing all, getting all muddy and dirty and so forth. Curse it in Jesus' name. You will not only do what I have done. See, that's the maximum. I'm here this morning to challenge you and to challenge your thinking to take it higher. Come on. Instead of, let's stop settling for and let's go to the maximum. Let's go to the highest level attainable. Thank you, Lord Jesus. See, the thing about it is, and what's been happening in the church nowadays, if we haven't had preachers to challenge us, we haven't had ministers to challenge us. I'm challenging you this morning. I'm telling you, you're capable. If you're a child of God, you are capable of believing for the impossible, even the ridiculous. Thank you, Lord Jesus. That's why I tell you, if we ever out on a cruise ship somewhere and that thing starts sinking, I'm walking ashore. Forget all this. I'm walking ashore. Thank you, Lord Jesus. No, Jesus said, you not only do what I've did, but greater. highest level attainable, the maximum. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Oh, okay. Is that good to you? God is good, isn't he? Let's go over to Isaiah 55 and Jeremiah chapter 1. Now, see, we got to understand something about the Word of God. The Word of God is anointed. Over in Luke 1:37, it says, no word from God is void of the power it takes to bring it to pass. No, not one word from God is void of the power it takes to bring it to pass. In other words, the anointing of God hovers over the Word of God. And it doesn't matter. I like to say this. Not only one word from God is void of the power it takes to bring it to pass. Not even a half of the Word of God is void of the power it takes to bring it to pass. Not even a quarter of the Word of God is void of the power. Not even an eighth of the Word is void of power. Thank you, Lord Jesus. The Word of God in itself is anointed. And when I say the Word, now listen, I want to qualify this. When I say the Word, I'm not just talking about the written Word. I'm not just talking about the Logos. I'm also talking about the Rhema, or the spoken Word. Yes. Whenever God gives a word, it's anointed, and this is what we need to know. Yes. Thank you, Lord Jesus. The Lord said over in Mark chapter 16, that they went everywhere preaching the Word, and the Lord was working with them, listen to this, confirming the Word with signs following. A lot of people miss that. Because when they read that, they think the confirmation of the Word is through the gifts of the Spirit. It is, but it's not limited to that. Yes. The confirmation of the Word that he is actually talking about is you go and preach it, and what you preach, I'll confirm it. Yes. Why? Because there's an anointing that hovers over the Word of God. Yes. So anytime the Word of the Lord go forth, God said, I'll confirm it. Yes. Whether it's the Logos, whether it's the Rhema, whether it's the prophetic word from the prophet or the preacher, thank you, Lord Jesus, or if it's a prophetic word that God has given every year at the beginning of the year, if it's a word from God, there's an anointing to bring it to pass. Let's read that. Isaiah chapter 55. Isaiah chapter 55 and 11 says, so shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth. It will not return unto me void, but it will accomplish that which I please, and it will prosper in the thing why I have sent it. The Word of God is anointed, and it doesn't make any difference where it goes. It will prosper, and it will accomplish whatever he sent it out to do. Then over in Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 12, it says, then said the Lord unto me, thou hast well seen, listen to this, for I will watch over my word to perform it. I will watch over my word to make it good. Thank you, Lord Jesus. So, at the beginning of the year, when the word of the Lord started going forth, God said, there's an anointing that carried it out. Now, this is important that you hear this, because I'm going to come back and talk about it. He said, there's an anointing there that carried that out. Like the word that that he gave me, don't stop ascending. Thank you, Lord Jesus. He said, there's an anointing there to keep you ascending. If you receive the word and believe the word, there's an anointing there to help you ascend and continue to ascend. Yes, yes, yes. The word that he gave Jezebel is, the year of the maximum, the highest level attainable. He said, there's an anointing there to carry that out. If you receive that, thank you, Lord Jesus, then you can start receiving maximum results. Thank you, Lord Jesus. He said there's an anointing there over that that's over my word to carry it out. What did he say over there in what book was that? When he said, believe in the Lord your God, so shall our Chronicles. When believe in the Lord God, so shall you be established. Listen to this. Believe his prophets, so shall you prosper. Thank you, Lord Jesus. God, when God gives us a word, God said there's an anointing. He said, see, I'm gonna help you out. I know you may have been believing for the bare minimum. I know you've been believing to just break even. I know you've been believing but just to come out. But I'm going to give you a word concerning the maximum. And it's going to help you do a quantum leap. Glory to God. It's going to help you do a quantum leap. You forget about the 30 and forget about the 60. He said, I want to give you the 100. Thank you, Lord Jesus. No, we have to understand and realize that God's word has gone forth and it will not return unto him void. Thank you, Lord Jesus. So when he gives us words, all he doing is waiting for us to act upon that word. Thank you, Lord Jesus. There is a maximum anointing right now that's hovering over the body of Christ. There is a continue to ascend anointing that's hovering over the body because he's given us a word. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Many times in prayer lines and stuff I've had, and you know, you wish sometimes you can stop and teach people, but you can't, especially if you got a long prayer line and you're trying to keep the service going. Thank you, Lord Jesus. But a lot of times when I'm preaching, you know, I say that I'm preaching a message on healing, or say that I'm preaching a message on dominion and authority over devils and demons and fear and so forth like that. Well, at the end of the message, say that I give an altar call and I say, okay, anybody off in here needs a healing, come on up. Anybody off in here that needs deliverance, come on up. When they come up, I'm laying hands on them. You know, now God has given the word. See, he's given the word. And so there's an anointing hovering in that service to bring that word to pass. And if you receive it and you come up and I lay hands on you, then you'll receive. But what I run into is this. A lot of times, not only me, but ministers, I see it all the time. When we lay hands on them, people stand there like, give it to me, preacher. I mean, it's like they come up and they just, even though I've preached the word, even though the anointing is here, there's still something you got to do. And oftentimes I tell the person, no, just the anointing is here. Open your mouth and say, Lord, I receive. And not only say, Lord, I receive, start thanking the Lord for, Lord, I receive that anointing right now. God, I thank you that I have the maximum anointing right now, Lord. I thank you, Lord, that I'm going to the next level. Lord, I thank you. And as you do that, that anointing comes out of me that's been hovering over the word and goes into you, and it breaks the yoke.
Yes.
But too many times I've seen people just stand by waiting for the anointing in the word. They come up like, and they just stand there like, okay, give it to me, preacher. But no, there's always something that you got to do.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. It ain't that the word doesn't work. The word works, but there's still something that you got to do.
Amen.
And something that the Lord told me, he said, I really, really, really desire to do for my children. I desire to do over, above, and beyond what they can believe for. I desire to do, take them to the maximum. Take them to the next level, the highest level attainable. He said, but they limit me because they won't believe me for it. God can only do for you what you can believe him for. He said, I have all this power. He said, and no parent desires to do for their children any more than I for mine. He said, I desire every one of my children to be rich, wealthy, famous, enjoying life. Come on. He said, I desire that for every last one of them. He said, but I can't go beyond what they believe. All of this power, all of this anointing, just waiting to give us our deepest heart's desire. Therefore, whatsoever thing you desire, when you pray, believe that you receive. The Lord say it hurts my heart when I see my children struggling and going through. Wouldn't it? You're a parent. You know what I'm talking about. If nothing else, you want to see your children prospering, and you want to see your children being in good health, and you want to see your children doing well. God say, I want to see my children healed, whole, wealthy, and doing well. But I cannot go beyond what they believe. So, if there's a limit on God, guess who put it on him?
Yes.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Okay, y'all still with me?
Amen.
You get anything out of this? Okay. Thank you, Lord God. Thank you, Lord. God is good, isn't he?
Yes, he is.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. just because you've gotten a word from the Lord doesn't mean it would automatically come to pass. This is a mistake too many believers make. According to Hebrews 4:2, you have to mix faith with the word of God in order for it to come to pass. You've got to mix your faith with it. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You know, Holly is a cake maker, a pie maker. Thank you, Lord Jesus. In order to make good cakes and good pies, she had to mix the right ingredients. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. I dare say you don't put salt in your pies, do you? Instead of putting sugar, she puts salt in there. And I'm like, oh my goodness. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Well, when it comes to getting something from God, you know, there is a mixture. We have to come up with a mixture. And in mixture, there has to be faith in the Word of God. Outside of that, it doesn't work. You know, it's just like this. It's almost like, well, this is back in the day. It may still be today. I mean, you know that instant milk? All you got to do is do what? Add water. See? yeah. you know, add water. Back in the day, they had instant eggs. Y'all remember that government stuff? that government stuff. Just add water. oh, my goodness. My goodness. Back in the day, they had this instant stuff. I mean, but all you had to do was just listen to this. Just add water. And you go to the store today, you know, they got some good pudding mixes and stuff like that. All you got to do is add water. Good pancake mix. All you got to do is add water. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Listen to this. Word of God, all you got to do is add faith. That's all you got to do. Word of God, all you got to do is add faith. Believing for your healing, add faith. Believing for your finances, add faith. Believing for, you know, your house to be paid off, add faith. Believing to cast the devil out of those crazy kids, add faith. So all you got to do is add faith. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Over in Hebrews 4:2, it says, for unto us was the gospel preached as well as unto them, but the word, listen to this, preached did not profit them. Why? Not being mixed with faith. It did not mix any faith. So I'm telling you, God gives us a word practically every year. Y'all know that. Gives us a word every year. But it does no good if you don't add faith. Thank you, Lord Jesus. A man of God can, and I've seen this happen a lot, a man of God can call you up and say, thus saith the Lord, and begin to give you a prophetic word, an anointed prophetic word from God. But if you leave and say, okay, I'm going to see if that's going to come to pass, you'll never see it. You'll never see it. I remember, this is how I got started in ministry. Prophet called me up and said, thus saith the Lord, preach, carry my word, so forth and so on. You know what I did? I went out and bought a PA set and some equipment. I mean, I was ready to preach. Not only did I go out and buy a PA set and equipment, but I also bought office furniture, typewriters, computers, and copiers. I mean, you know, just, I mean, he shouldn't have never told me, thus saith the Lord, go preach, because I got ready. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I'm saying, add faith. Add faith. The word, without adding faith with the word of God, it won't do you any good. So, I mean, you know, this word that I'm sharing now that God has given us at the beginning of the year, continue to ascend in the maximum level or the highest level attainable, it won't do you any good if you don't add any faith to it. Okay? Thank you, Lord Jesus. Glory to God. God is good, isn't he? Now, let me get again, talk a little bit about what the Lord said to me about no one is really actually believing him for the greater. Over the last couple of years, the Lord has been challenging me to believe him for the greater. And I truly mean that God has been challenging me to believe him for the impossible and the ridiculous. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Because he says no one is actually trying to believe for this. They're just basically believing for the basic needs and so forth and so on. But they're not reaching for the miraculous and the ridiculous. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And when he told me that, he gave me these scriptures right here. You might want to turn there, Matthew chapter 21. Show you what I'm talking about. Matthew 21, John 14, Mark 11. Oh, we're coming around the corner right now. Matthew 21:21, Jesus answered and said unto them, verily I say unto you, If you believe and doubt not, that's what faith is. Faith is the heart's belief. If you believe and doubt not, you should not only do this which is done to the fig tree. Okay, now I like to stop it. You should not only do what I have done. You should not only do what I have done. If you believe and doubt not, you should not only do what I have done. Jesus, the Son of God, God incarnate, God in the flesh said, if you believe, you can do what I do. If you believe, you can do what I, you should not only do what I have done to the fig tree. Again, I say, you may not have fig trees, but you may have weeds growing in your garden. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Amen. You may have bugs trying to invade your house. You may have bugs trying to invade your house, multi-legged creatures, rodents and stuff. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Jesus said, you should not only do what I have done. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Now, see, folks, saying, I never thought about that, Pastor. Yeah, see, that's what I'm saying. You need somebody to bring it to your attention. This is what the Lord is telling you. The Lord is challenging you. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Why go out and get pay money for a pest control and get out there and get all dirty in your garden and stuff? Just speak to it. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You should not only do what I've done to the fig tree, but also if you were saying to this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, it shall be done in all things. Now notice verse 22, in all things. That's not I-N, that's A-N-D. A conjunction. I think we missed that. He said, in all things, whatever you shall ask, in other words, whatever you ask concerning anything, whatever you ask concerning anything, if you believe, you can have. Now see, that right there is maximum. Right there is highest level. Whatever. Whatever. I mean, if that's cursing bugs and cursing plants, come on, somebody. Believing for stuff to be paid off, believing for healing, believing for wholeness, believing for an arm to grow back, come on. Believing for blinded eyes to come open, whatever. Whatever. You may be sitting in a wheelchair right now. Whatever. Amen. Whatever.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
See, that's maximum.
Yes.
That's the highest level obtainable.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. Then over in Mark 11:22. Jesus answering and said unto them, listen to this, believe in God, have faith in God, believe in God. For verily I say unto you, that whosoever shall say unto this mountain, who is whosoever? That's anybody. That whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart. That mountain will say, excuse me, I got to get up and get out of here. Again, listen to this. Let's be careful now. Let's not dumb down the word of God. Again, cause you people say, yeah, he wasn't talking about a literal mountain. Yeah, he was. Somebody said, well, why would anybody want to tell a mountain to get up and move out the way? I don't know. Maybe it's in the way. I mean, why would anybody want to say to a mountain? But no, but the fact that he or God said, you can say to this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea. Now, yes, metaphorically, that applies. I mean, that could be certain mountains that's in your life. But in not dumbing down the word of God, he meant what he said. And I don't have any problem that believing that a God created the universe can move a mountain. I have no problem believing that at all. Thank you, Lord Jesus. See, that's maximum. That's highest level obtainable. He said, no one is believing me for that. He said, but yet, it's available to every one of us that believes. It's available. Glory to God. He went on to say, verse 24, therefore I say unto you, what things soever you desire, what do you desire? Note that he didn't say what you want. Note that he didn't say what you need. He said whatever you desire. See, that's maximum right there. Whatever you desire. My God, if I desire, don't look at me funny now. If I desire an Escalade, if I desire a Rolls Royce, if I desire a Bentley, if I desire, come on somebody, if I desire all of these vehicles, that's my desire. Come on somebody. He said I can have them. And then if I get, you know, about 6, 7, 8, 9 cars, I'm going to need a house with a car, you know, with you know what I'm talking about, with about 8, 9 driveways. So I got to believe God for a big enough house to keep them in. Now, am I blowing your mind this morning? I mean, is your mind about to go tilt? Listen, I'm telling you. I'm telling you, he said, this is the year. Believe me for it now. There's an anointing over this year to carry that word out, to get you from barely being having it, barely doing it, to the maximum.
Yes, yes, yes.
There's an anointing for it. Because, see, I was telling the Lord, Lord, how people going to believe you for the maximum when they barely can believe you for just getting by? How are they going to believe you for the maximum? I mean, I hear the word, but he said, what you're missing is I've given my word. I've given the anointing. The anointing is on my word. It will help them get to the maximum. It would help them believe for the maximum. It would help them get it if they believe it. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Many a time I've been in services and God has given me a word to preach. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And when I preach that word, there's an anointing there to carry it out. And people that have been trying to get healed for years got healing. People that are trying to be filled with the Holy Ghost for years got filled. People that, I remember one guy who hadn't walked, was in a wheelchair. I mean, you know, and he walked. Why? Because of the word. Glory to God. Last one. Let's go over to John chapter 14. Thank you, Lord Jesus. 14:12. Verily, verily, I say unto you, listen to this. He that believeth on me, the works that I do. See, I told you. See, I was reading that over there in Matthew. You thought, you know, that, okay, you're changing scriptures. No. Right here it is. Jesus said, what I do, you can do. John 14, the works that I do, you can do. He that believeth on me. Anybody often here believes on Jesus? Basically, he was talking about the born-again Christian, not just everybody. He was talking about the born-again Christian because the child of God that has been born again has truly believed on him. Thank you, Lord Jesus. If you know you've been born again, you have believed on him. And because you believed on him, he's talking to you.
Amen.
Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that believeth on me, listen to this, the works that I do shall he do. What I do, he basically saying this, what I do, you can do. What I do, you can do. My goodness, wait a minute, let's stop and think about that. What did he do?
Yeah.
Are you ready for this? Wait a minute, let's stop and think about this. What did he do? He walked on the sea. What did he do? He spoke to a storm. Recently, we just had a horrendous tornado come through Little Rock, Arkansas. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I mean, you know, it was an F4. Thank you, Lord Jesus. What did Jesus, what would Jesus do? What would Jesus do? Jesus would have spoke to him and said, peace, be still.
Amen.
Come on, let's stop and think about it. What did Jesus do? He raised the dead. What did Jesus do? He opened blinded eyes. Come on, let's stop and think about it. What did Jesus do? He fed a multitude with a little boy's lunch. What did Jesus do? He cast out devils.
Yes.
He healed the sick.
Yes.
He raised the dead. What did Jesus do? He said, the works that I do shall you do.
Yes. Hallelujah.
That's maximum. Yes. That's the highest level obtainable. He said, you can do it.
Hallelujah.
You can do it.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord Jesus. No, he said, verily, he that believeth upon me, the works that I do shall he do also. And now, if, in case that didn't get you, he said, and greater.
Yeah.
Oh, my goodness.
Thank you.
And greater. Not only what I did, and then when you stop and think about what he did, and then he said, and greater.
Yes, amen.
Oh, my goodness. That's maximum. That's highest level attainable right there. God said, no one's trying to believe me for that anymore. Nobody's even reaching out to try to believe for that. He said, but yet I said they can do it, and yet they are capable of doing it.
Yes, 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 yes.
You just need somebody. He just needs somebody to challenge you to get in the word and do it. Okay, we got to close out. Oh, my goodness. Glory, glory to God. Man, I tell you what, I can run right about now. The Lord told me, I meant what I said. All these statements has to do with maximum results. What I just read you, all of them have to do with maximum results. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Question again, why are we settling for the crumbs that's falling from the master's table? Thank you, Lord Jesus. Now, when you say a crumb, what are you talking about? Again, believing for just immediate healing and stuff like that, that's a crumb. You want maximum. You want to walk in divine health the rest of the days of your life. And then when you get to the end of your life, you don't want to die of no sickness or anything like that. You want to get all your loved ones around you and tell them, hey, y'all, goodbye. And hey, you act right. Junebug, you better stop that and so forth and so on. And tell them everything. You're right. And then say, okay, bye-bye. See y'all when you get to heaven. That's the way you're supposed to die. That's the way you're supposed to die. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Notice them under the Old Testament Bible said they got their loved ones around them, told them, you know, everything that they need to tell them. Then they gathered their legs up in the bed and they went on to be with their fathers. Glory to God. If you're believing for crumbs, oh, listen to this. Financial needs to be met. That's a crumb. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You don't want to be believing for financial needs to be met. You want to believe that everything is paid for and you got more than enough left over. Amen. Amen. To give into this ministry and the sinners around the world. Glory to God. Amen. Believing that, to believing to make notes on houses, cars, crumbs. Believing to heal your marriage, crumb. Come on, somebody. The Bible says not only will you be saved, but your house. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I don't care what those unsaved folks say in my house. They are marked. They are marked for salvation. I don't care what they say. I don't care how hard and how long they run. How hard and how long they run. They are marked.
Amen.
They are marked. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I said, boy, ain't no sense in you. Go home and tell him, boy, ain't no sense in you running from me and the Lord. You saved, whether you realize it or not. I said, I'm going to tell him, Dale, you saved, whether you realize it or not. Glory to God. Oh, I better close here. Thank you, Lord Jesus. The church has been taught enough that they are, the church hasn't been taught enough that they are capable of doing the miraculous and the impossible. This morning, again, I wanted to challenge you to believe that you are a miracle going somewhere to happen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Glory to God. When I say the maximum, just to be clear about it, when I say the maximum, I'm talking about, you know, if you were suffering from any terminal or chronic disease, I'm talking about walking in health. Thank you, Lord Jesus. If you are paying notes, I'm talking about, you know, paying it off. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Glory to God. Stop that devil in Jesus' name. If you have a limb or something, are you hearing me now? Because this is nobody off in here. But if you have a limb or something missing, or even if you're blind, I'm talking about the limb growing back and your eyes coming open. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Listen, again, this is the year for it. See, that's why we should be excited about it, because there's an anointing to carry that out. If God didn't mean it, he shouldn't have never said it. And you know, I told the Lord one time, I said, Lord, I'm going to take you at your word on that. He said, I hope you do. He said, Lord, I'm going to take your word on that. He said, I hope you do. And then he could throw one back at me. He said, I'm going to see if you will. Okay. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Gosh, I got so much more here. I'm not going to finish this. I'm sorry. I wanted to finish this. Thank you, Lord Jesus. But let's talk a little bit about believing for the maximum. No doubt the million-dollar question is, how can we believe for the maximum or the highest level attainable? Good question. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Now that you are capable, number one, if you're going to believe for the maximum, know that you're capable of it. You may not have it, but know that you are capable of it. You're capable of believing God for far more than what you are possessing or what you have right now. You are capable of it. You got to know that. Number two, believe the word and start acting accordingly. What word? Believe that this word concerning the maximum and the highest level attainable and start acting accordingly. Stop going around fretting about, you know, what the doctor said. Stop going around fretting about your financial situation. Stop going around fretting about what the president is talking about or what the government is talking about. Come on, somebody. Amen. Start acting like you believe what God said. No, I have the highest level attainable. I'm believing for the maximum. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Number three, stop settling for crumbs. Now, well, I really need time to talk about that one because we really got to just stay. Glory to God. Hallelujah. God is good, isn't he? And all the time, God is good. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Stop. Let's just stop believing in settling for the ordinary or just enough. Let's start going for the ridiculous and the miraculous and the maximum and the highest level attainable. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Bob, in your business, go for the highest level attainable. In your garden planting, get 100-fold, man. Man, I planted tomatoes. I only got about half of them. No, get 100-fold. Go for the highest level attainable. Nick, when you go hunting, man, get that white-tailed deer, whatever it is. Yeah, I mean, go for the 100-fold. Go for the maximum. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Now number four. Listen to this one. This one you ain't gonna like too much. Be willing to press. Paul said, I press toward the mark, inferring that in order to get the maximum or the highest level attainable, you're going to encounter resistance. The devil, the flesh, and the world is going to try to tell you don't have it and that you're stupid and crazy for even thinking you do. Why? Because when you're talking about the maximum, you are talking about the ridiculous. you're talking about... So be ready to encounter opposition. Paul said, I press toward the mark of the prize of the high calling. So keep on pressing and be steadfast in your pressing, in your believing, in your confessing, in your talking, in your acting. Press. Press. Keep. I like to say it like this. Keep your faith pressure turned up. Keep your faith pressure on the sickness. Keep your faith pressure on the circumstances. Keep your faith pressure on the situation. Keep your faith pressure on. Keep it turned up. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Number five, listen to this. Be determined. I don't know about you, but like I say, if God didn't want me to have the maximum, he should have never said nothing to me about it. Because right now, I will not stop until I have the maximum and the highest level attainable. And I'm serious. I'm determined about it. Concerning the healing and health of my body. I mean, you know, when the devil is trying to attack my body, I'm going like, I don't have time for this. I am healed. You know I'm healed. Stop trying. Amen. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Keep the faith pressure on and be determined. I mean, you know, this morning, man, he spoke something in my ear and I just started laughing. I say, Lord, I got to give it to the booger. He is relentless, isn't he? I mean, you know, he's constant. He's relentless. And the Lord said, yeah, learn a lesson from him. Be relentless. Be relentless. Okay? Be determined. Number six. Well, you know I was going to give you this one right here. Meditate daily. Actually, this is the key that's going to make everything work. Remember that message? Meditation is the key. This is the key that's going to make everything work. If you don't meditate and get you, have you a regimen of meditation and reading in the word, you're going to have a hard time trying to obtain the maximum or the highest level obtainable. So, I mean, you know, make sure you're meditating on the daily verses. And then I'm going to close out with this right here. Number seven, don't be moved. Don't be moved by what a doctor say. Don't be moved by what you feel. Don't be moved by what you see. Don't be moved by what they're saying on the evening news. Don't be moved by don't be moved by what unbelieving, believing Christians will say. Don't be moved. I mean, you know, be like be like one of those. I don't know what kind of snapping turtle that is, but then when that thing snaps you, I mean, the way them to get them loose, you probably gonna have to cut their neck off. I mean, because they will not let you go. Think there are some dogs like that too, that once they get a hold of you and grab you, and they will not let you go. Thank you. I mean, you can beat them, kick them. I mean, they will not let you go. God say, be determined. and don't be moved. Don't be moved. I don't care what it is the devil try to throw you away. I don't care what the devil try to say. In each and every morning that you wake up, there it is staring you in the face again. God say, be determined and don't be moved. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Why? Because this is the year of the maximum. This is the year of the highest level obtainable. Thank you, Lord Jesus. And don't be moved until you see it. Why? Because you are capable of it. You can do it. You're capable of it. You're capable of divine health. You're capable of divine health. You're capable of divine wealth and prosperity. You're capable of it. Man, Nick, Bob, we ain't got time to sit around and mess with all this stuff, business and stuff like that. We're capable of believing that those business will support itself. We need to be going around the world. We need to be preaching the gospel, raising up churches and stuff. Amen. We're capable of doing it. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We're going to do it. We're going to get the highest level attainable. Come on, stand. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Woo! I feel like one.